This is a FUJIFILM Sonosite webinar. I am Vandy Gaffney, a board certified fellowship trained regional anesthesiologist and acute pain medicine specialist practicing in Atlanta, Georgia. And this webinar is about ultrasound guided pectoralis 1 and 2 blocks. So let's get started. Pectoralis 1 and 2 blocks. So the objective of this webinar are to discuss the indications and clinical usage for pectoralis 1 and 2 blocks. We will discuss the anatomical and sonographic anatomy of the thorax, anterior lateral chest wall, and the axillary, illustrate the proper needle and local anesthetic placement for a successful pectoralis 1 and 2 block, and discuss some clinical pearls for performing ultrasound-guided regional anesthesia. Pectoralis 1 and 2 blocks are interfascial plane blocks, very similar to the tap block of the abdomen. These are relatively new techniques for surgeries of the breast, anterior lateral chest wall, and the thorax. And some have even coined them as the tap block of the thorax. The clinical indications for these two blocks are surgical anesthesia for breast surgery, such as mastectomy and lumpectomy, thorax surgery, such as your open thoracotomy or VATS video assisted thoracic surgery, as well as getting infraclavicular analgesia and anesthesia for clavicle fractures, and anterior lateral chest wall surgery, such as central venous access catheter placements, port placements, chest tube placements. The surgery also works very well for percutaneous cholecystostomy tube placements, sentinel lymph node dissections and surgeries of the axilla, as well as any mass excisions or reconstructive procedures of the breast and anterior lateral chest wall. These two blocks also are very good for postoperative analgesia. So the clinical goals. The target of the pectoralis 1 and 2 blocks are the median lateral pectoral nerves. This is done by local anesthetic hydrodissection of the interfascial plane between the pectoralis major and minor muscles at the level of the third rib. The target of the pectoralis 2 block are the pectoral nerves and the intercostal branches of the anterior lateral chest wall. This is achieved by local anesthetic hydrodissection of the interfascial plane between the pectoralis minor and the serratus anterior muscles at the level of the third and fourth rib. Reviewing the anatomy, the four muscles relevant to pectoralis blocks are the pectoralis major and minor muscles, the serratus anterior, and the subclavius muscle. The pectoralis major and minor muscles are innervated by the lateral and pectoral nerves. Serratus anterior muscle is innervated by the long thoracic nerve, and the subclavius muscle is innervated by the upper trunk of the brachial plexus. And looking at specifically neuronal innervation, the lateral pectoral nerve comes off the lateral cord of the brachial plexus and innervates the pectoralis major. The medial pectoral nerve comes up the medial cord and innervates both the pectoralis major and minor muscles. The long thoracic nerve comes up the C5 to C7 nerve roots and innervates the serratus anterior muscle. The thoracodorsal nerve comes up the posterior cord of the brachial plexus and innervates the latissimus dorsi. And the intercostal nerves are the anterior rami of the thoracic spinal nerves, and they supply sensory innervation to the anterior lateral chest wall and breast. Whenever you're doing ultrasound-guided regional anesthesia, it is important to maximize ergonomics and patient positioning. For this block in particular, the patient is supine with the ipsilateral arm adducted to 90 degrees or down by the side. It is operator preference. Normally, I choose to have the arm abducted to 90 degrees whenever I'm performing a block on a patient as redundant soft tissue in the area of needle placement. The operator is positioned at the head of the bed on the ipsilateral side of the patient. The transducer probe is placed in the infraclavicular anterior lateral chest wall around the anterior axillary line. It's placed in an oblique orientation, advancing from medial to lateral. Needle placement is an in-plane technique behind the probe, also advancing medial to lateral. and your desired local anesthetic spread is a hydrogen section between the interfascial planes between the desired muscle groups. So here you have a photo of the operator, which is myself, standing on the ipsilateral side, ipsilateral side of the patient at the head of the bed. The ultrasound is placed in short distance from the operator and patient for easy ergonomics. The head of the patient's head is turned to the ipsilateral side, and the needle and probe are placed infraclavicular at the anterior axillary line in an oblique orientation, scanning from medial to lateral. So, reviewing the sonographic anatomy, the major landmarks for ultrasound guidance, pectoralis 1 and 2 blocks are your pectoralis major and minor muscles, the serratus anterior muscle, the thoracoacromial artery, and the third and fourth ribs. So in this static photo, going from top to bottom, you see the skin and subcutaneous tissue, and then you see the pectoralis major and minor muscles with the serratus anterior muscle between the level of the third and fourth rib. If this was a dynamic motion photo, you would see the shimmering and sliding of the pleura at the bottom of the page. When choosing the local anesthetic for your blocks, for a single injection for a unilateral pectoralis 1 and 2 block, 20 to 30 milliliters of 0.5% ropivacaine or 0.25% bupivacaine are used. For a unilateral pectoralis 1 and 2 blocks, you use 15 to 20 mLs of 0.5% ropivacaine or 0.25% bupivacaine at each target injection site for around the total between 30 to 40 milliliters of local anesthetic given. Because this is an interfascial plane block with no targeting of a specific peripheral nerve, liposomal bupivacaine or Expiro can be used for longer acting analgesia in combination with 0.25% bupivacaine. Typically 5 to 10 mLs of the liposomal bupivacaine is added to the 0.25% bupivacaine for injection. So as discussed earlier, the technique is the transducer probe is placed on the chest below the level of the clavicle and is advanced in oblique orientation laterally until you visualize the pectoralis minor and serratus anterior muscles. If you go further with the probe, you can see the third and fourth rib. In plane needle trajectory with the tip visualized in the desired location, and the local anesthetic is injected at two points for a pectoralis 1 block. It's between the pectoralis major and minor muscles, and for a pectoralis 2 block, the local anesthetic injection is made between the pectoralis minor and serratus anterior muscles. So here in this video, you see the pectoralis major and minor muscles. The needle is introduced from right to left. It's coming into visualization now. And as the needle is piercing the interfascial plane, actually overshot here a bit, and after aspiration you can see the anesthetic is deposited. Here is an actual intramuscular injection, so the needle is withdrawn even further, and here you have a pectoralis 1 block between the two planes of the pectoralis major and minor muscles. The needle is then advanced further between the interfascial planes of the pectoralis minor and serratus anterior muscles. After aspiration, you see here another intramuscular injection where the needle is then advanced a little further between the two levels, between the two interfascial planes, between the pectoralis minor and serratus anterior muscles. And you can see the hydrodissection of those two muscles for a pectoralis 2 block. So the limitations of the pectoralis 1 and 2 blocks. So it only provides, the analgesia is limited to the anterior lateral chest wall and axilla only, with no blockade of thoracic viscera. The landmarks can be difficult to identify in patients with altered anatomy or in patients who have redundant soft tissue. The chest wall moves with respiration, so even the smallest movement may displace the needle out of visualization during block performance. And some clinical pearls for performing ultrasound-guided regional anesthesiology. So sonographic target visualization and image optimization are the hallmarks of a successful ultrasound-guided regional anesthesia block. So probe and needle alignment improves tips positioning and to improve the effectiveness of your block. So you can use the size of the ultrasound to gauge the depth of your target. Then you would want to have the initial needle insertion should be at the approximately the same distance away from your probe that your target is on the screen. This allows for a more perpendicular beam and needle alignment to increase visualization after skin insertion. And you want to optimize the ergonomics and patient position to decrease your block failure. Here are my references. And thank you for your time and attention.